Thanks to all the contributors and collaborators on this event who have worked so hard behind the scenes to put this together. As Pat mentioned, I am a director of an on-campus physical and engineering, physical sciences and engineering incubator, and our location is a really useful part of our value proposition in that we're located immediately above the semiconductor fab in the Duffield Hall facility, and that makes it a very easy transition from a research project to a commercialization effort. It also is by coincidence the location where some of the academic contributors have their own academic labs, and in some cases they're walking across the hall from their academic lab to their startup lab back and forth. And so we follow a pretty normal process of helping the startups reach out through the Cornell alumni network, reach out to other academic units on campus, and then we reach out to the other off-campus resources, such as the wonderful resources of Red Bear Angels. And that leads me to my next introduction, which is to Maggie Reagan, who is going to introduce the Red Bear Angels organization. So take it away, Maggie.
Thank you so much. And thanks to all the sponsors, panelists, our moderator, the startups, and especially to Linda for making the event possible today. My name is Maggie Reagan, the Director of Community at Red Bear Angels. And for those that don't know, Red Bear Angels was established shortly after the Cornell Tech launch in New York City by a group of Cornell alum who saw a need to reinforce the connections between amazing entrepreneurs that come out of Cornell and investors that want to advise and invest in them. Today, we've invested over $10 million from angels across 30 different portfolio companies, and we've built a network of Cornell-related support to source, perform diligence, and to drive growth for these early-stage companies. We have a solid group of active members who have access to RBA's deal flow, much of which comes from Cornell organizations like the Praxis Center and the Center for Technology and Licensing at Cornell. This year already, we've made two new investments into companies that work with CTL and the Praxis Center. So we're grateful for those connections. RBA is industry agnostic, and we review a full spectrum of investment opportunities. Some areas that we thrive in and our members have deep expertise and an investment focus include technology, healthcare, decentralization, fintech, consumer products and services, food and beverage, and education, to name a few. And like most of you, or all of you on the phone, I should say, we believe that Cornell is an entrepreneurial powerhouse, and we seek to actively support the entrepreneurs and their innovative businesses that are coming out of Cornell. Our partnership with CTL and the Praxis Center are just some of the ways that we stay connected to Cornell partners. So I'm looking forward to the event. Thank you so much for having Red Bear, and thanks again for everyone joining. If anyone has any questions on Red Bear or anything throughout the Zoom, I will be available on email and on chat to answer anything, technical difficulties, Red Bear Angel specific questions, anything at all. So please feel free to reach out. And I will hand it over to back to Rick Barr, I believe.
Think Rich is maybe first on that.
Oh. Perfect.
Hi, I'm Rich Curtin. I'm a managing partner at Silicon Catalyst, and I'm also in charge of business operations for the Silicon Catalyst Angel Group. But more importantly, I'm a graduate of Cornell. I'm wearing this shirt thanks to Bob getting me back involved in Praxis as a mentor. And I'm really pleased to be able to present an overview of Silicon Catalyst. So this is going to be a 3-minute elevator pitch. So Rick, please make sure you set the timer. The key is that we're a incubator accelerator headquartered in Silicon Valley and basically working with startups on a worldwide basis. Our motto is very simple. It's about what's next, and it's all centered around innovation. Innovation is driving things across the board from a consumer side to an industrial side, and now to a societal impact as well. And our focus is specifically on semiconductor solutions, which is everything from IP, MEMS, and sensors. Just a little bit of background. Rick Lisansky is on the call today. He's actually started this endeavor back in 2015, looking at the industry as a whole, which is R&D spending was down and significantly the startups were down. And really what's happened is at looking at that as a challenge, how do you really create innovative cycles within the semiconductor industry? And so kick things off, and now we're in our sixth year of operation. And it's really an interesting collection of application segments as well as technology segments. This chart of elements is really sort of the beginning of our landscape as to what we're addressing in terms of market verticals as well as technology side. And so really, if you look at what's gone on in the last couple of years with the reemergence of interest in semiconductors, I think we hit the mark really well, and we're really catching the wave of what's gone on in innovation in the semiconductor space. As sort of our secret sauce as to how do we do this, very clearly working with universities like Cornell, whether it be entrepreneurial teams spinning out of universities or even industry spinouts, what we do is we start a very rigorous screening process. And it's over the last 5+ years, we've looked at probably over 350 early stage companies. And we go through a fairly rigorous screening. And once they come in, we really provide the value add of basically participating in an incubator. So we have a 24-month incubation cycle where we're working with the startup team and really helping them grow a technology base as well as a market traction base. And then more importantly, to help them get the capital, the working capital, to expand their business. So we have a very close working relationship with advisors, with investors, as well as what we call in-kind partners. And so at the end of the day, the ultimate goal is to deliver viable companies solving real-world problems in the market with a semiconductor focus. The inside baseball story about what we're up to as to how we do this is this sphere at the center is the startup team that we then work with across our advisor network, as well as what we call in-kind partners. I'll explain in a moment. We have quite a network of investors that we work with as part of the nurturing of the startups, as well as strategic partners. And the strategic partners are really a really interesting collection across the industry of semiconductor companies, as well as equipment and Soitec as an example of a wafer provider, basically engineered substrates, as well as ARM, ON, and the others. And so the real key here is if you look at our in-kind partner network as a sample, we have some major solution providers for basically getting to silicon and getting into the market. And I'll explain that a little bit on the next slide. Very specifically, the rest of the organization as to how we support the startups. We have international operations. We have two partners in Israel. We have a joint venture in Chengdu, China, focused on power electronics. We work closely with universities, as an example today, as well as industry organizations. And we've also extended our reach into other incubators, accelerators, as VentureLab and Octane. So what is an in-kind partner? Effectively, what we're doing is removing the significant barrier of an early stage semiconductor startup in providing goods and services. So we like to think about this as everything from pre-silicon to post-silicon to establishing a business. How do you really set up corporate accounts, corporate attorneys, as well as just the fundamental design tools to be able to get silicon out into early customers' hands? The other extension that we've done in the last 6-8 months is we've focused on expanding our footprint into the MEMS space. And very, very pleased to say that Giga out of Cornell is now a member of the Silicon Catalyst Incubating Solution. This is an overview of the MEMS development an ecosystem. We can go into a lot more detail maybe on the breakout session for those individuals that are interested. Last but not least, there's an open invitation to everyone on this webinar today. We've been holding these thought leadership forums, and we have one coming up next month. And it's a really interesting collection of panelists, really esteemed individuals. Don Clark, who's going to be the moderator from the New York Times. We've got Mark from Morgan Stanley. And Kim is focused on frontier tech, and her expertise is on space, which is why I think we looked at the edge theme for today. And then last but not least is Jody Shelton, who's the co-founder of the Global Semiconductor Alliance, which is an organization focused on serving the needs of the semiconductor industry. And so just to close things off, there's a lot more information on our website. For those entrepreneurial team that might be listening in today, we have an application deadline of January. So if you are interested, just go check out the website. And otherwise, just shoot me an email, and we'd love to hear from you. So with that, I'd like to, I don't know if I hit the 3 minutes there, Rick, but small world that it is, Rick and I go way back. So I graduated from Cornell in 78 and joined up with a chip startup within the mini computer era. So talk about innovation. Things have come a long way since Rick and I worked on CPUs. But let me hand it over to my esteemed colleague and friend and company mate at Prime Computer.